Today we will study about the gluteal region. The gluteal region, it extends from iliac crest above to the gluteal fold below. This is a dissected specimen of the left lower limb, and this one is the medial side where we can see in sagittal section the sacrum bone. And this is the iliac crest, posterior superior iliac spine and anterior superior iliac spine. We can see from where the sartorius, it is taking origin. In the gluteal region, we will study total 10 muscles. Three are the glutei muscles: gluteus maximus, gluteus medius and gluteus minimus. The other short muscles of the gluteal region, they are the piriformis, obturator internus and obturator externus, gemellus superior and gemellus inferior, quadratus femoris and tensor fascia lata muscles. The first muscle which we will see in the gluteal region, this is the gluteus maximus. So when we reflect the skin, superficial fascia and deep fascia, we can see this large muscle, that is the gluteus maximus. Fibers of the gluteus maximus, they can be seen running downward and laterally. This gluteus maximus muscle will cover all other structures in the gluteal region. So as we reflect the gluteus maximus, we can see the other two glutei muscles. One is this gluteus medius muscle. And when we reflect the gluteus medius muscle, we can see the third gluteal muscle of the gluteal region. This is the gluteus minimus. So first muscle, gluteus maximus. Then we can see the gluteus medius. And once reflect the gluteus medius, this is the gluteus minimus muscle. So as we move from posterior to anterior side of the iliac gluteal surface, we will reach up to the gluteus minimus muscle. The fourth muscle of the gluteal region, this is the tensor fascia lata muscle. Here we can see from anterior superior iliac spine up to the tubercle of iliac crest, this is the tensor fascia lata muscle of the gluteal region. Now, other muscles of the gluteal region which are present under the cover of gluteus maximus, we can identify first, this is the gluteus medius, and below the gluteus medius, this triangular muscle, that is the piriformis muscle. This is the key muscle of the gluteal region with reference to whom all other structures will be identified. At the lower border of piriformis muscle, we can see this largest nerve, that is the sciatic nerve. And on the bed of the sciatic nerve, the other muscles of the gluteal region which can be seen here, they are the gemellus superior, then tendon of obturator internus, then gemellus inferior. So piriformis, gemellus superior, tendon of obturator internus, gemellus inferior. And the last muscle in the gluteal region, this is the quadratus femoris. And the two bony points which we can identify at this level, this is the ischial tuberosity, from where all hamstring muscles, they are taking origin. And this one is the greater trochanter of the femur. And between these two, we can see this sciatic nerve. Now about the origin and insertion of these muscles. First about the three glutei muscle. And out of the three, first we are studying the gluteus maximus muscle. We have marked on the gluteal surface of the ilium three gluteal lines. The posterior gluteal line towards the posterior superior iliac spine. Then we have this anterior gluteal line, and third is this inferior gluteal line. The gluteus maximus, it will take origin from the gluteal surface of ilium behind the posterior gluteal line, and also from the dorsal surface of the sacrum and the coccyx. And the fibers of the gluteus maximus, they will also take origin from the sacrotuberous ligament, which extend from the posterior superior iliac spine to the ischial tuberosity. So this is the origin of gluteus maximus muscle. Now fibers, they will run downward and laterally. And most of the fibers of gluteus maximus, they will be inserted onto the iliotibial tract, that is the thickened part of the deep fascia of the thigh, fascia lata. So much of the fibers of gluteus maximus, they will be inserted in the iliotibial tract, but the deeper fibers of gluteus maximus, they will reach up to the gluteal tuberosity on the posterior surface of the femur. So this is the origin of the gluteus maximus from area behind the posterior gluteal line, dorsal surface of sacrum and coccyx, and also sacrotuberous ligament, and insertion is onto the iliotibial tract and deep fibers onto the gluteal tuberosity of the femur. Now, origin of gluteus medius. The gluteus medius muscle, it will take origin from the gluteal surface of ilium in the area between the posterior and the anterior gluteal line. So here will be the origin of gluteus medius. Insertion of gluteus medius, it will be onto the on a ridge on the lateral surface of the greater trochanter. So this will be the gluteus medius from area between posterior and anterior gluteal line up to the lateral surface of greater trochanter. Now the third muscle, gluteus minimus, it will take origin from the area between the anterior and the inferior gluteal line, and it will be inserted onto the ridge on the anterior surface of the greater trochanter. So as in the origin we may move from posterior to anterior side, that is gluteus maximus, medius and minimus, on the insertion also we move from posterior surface of femur, lateral surface of greater trochanter, and minimus it reaches up to the anterior surface of the greater trochanter. So in the dissection also we can see the insertion of gluteus maximus. So most of the fibers of the gluteus maximus, they are inserted onto this iliotibial tract, which is the thickened lateral part of the fascia lata. And the deeper fibers of the gluteus maximus, they are attached onto the gluteal tuberosity on the posterior surface of femur. Now gluteus medius, here we can see this gluteus medius muscle, which is inserted onto the lateral surface of the greater trochanter. And the third muscle, that is the gluteus minimus, it can be seen reaching onto the anterior surface of the greater trochanter. So these are the three glutei muscles, gluteus maximus, medius and the minimus muscle. Now nerve supply of these muscles, the gluteus maximus muscle, it will be supplied by the inferior gluteal nerve, while the gluteus medius and minimus, they will be supplied by the superior gluteal nerve. Both are the branches from the sacral plexus. Regarding the action of these muscles, first about the gluteus maximus muscle. The gluteus maximus muscle, it is the chief extensor at the hip joint. That is, it will help to raise the trunk from the stooping down position, and it will help in maintaining the erect posture. Now other actions of gluteus maximus, they are, it is also an abductor and lateral rotator of the thigh. So chief extensor at the hip joint or the thigh, it is the gluteus maximus muscle. Now the gluteus medius and the minimus muscle, the gluteus medius and minimus, both are the abductor and medial rotators of the thigh. Other action of gluteus medius and minimus are that they will raise the pelvis of the opposite side. For example, when we are walking, if our left lower limb it is supported on the ground and we raise our right limb, at this time the pelvis of the unsupported side it is raised because of the action of the gluteus medius and the minimus of the left side. Because there is a tendency for the unsupported side to fall down due to gravity, but this tendency will be prevented by the gluteus medius and minimus of the left side, which will raise the pelvis of the right side. So the action of gluteus medius and minimus, they are abductors, medial rotator of the thigh, and also they will raise the pelvis of the opposite side. Now about the origin of piriformis muscle. The piriformis muscle will have an E-shaped origin from the pelvic surface of the sacrum. It will take origin from second, third and fourth piece of the sacrum. Now after taking origin from the pelvic surface of the sacrum, the muscle it will pass through the greater sciatic notch. So here this is the greater sciatic notch. So muscle it will pass through the greater sciatic notch and it will get inserted onto the tip of the greater trochanter. So this will be the origin and insertion of the piriformis from pelvic surface of sacrum, then it will pass through the greater sciatic notch and inserted onto the tip of the greater trochanter. And we can also see in the dissection that here this is the greater sciatic notch from which the piriformis muscle it is passing, and it is inserted up to the tip of the greater trochanter. And now the obturator internus muscle. The obturator internus muscle, it will take origin from the pelvic surface of the ischium, inner surface of ischiopubic rami, and also from the pelvic surface of the obturator membrane. So this complete will be the origin of the obturator internus. Now after taking origin from obturator membrane and pelvic surface, the tendon of obturator internus, it will bend at right angle in the gap between the ischial spine and the ischial tuberosity. So with this white paper we have marked the 90 degree bend of the tendon of obturator internus, and from here along with the gemellus superior and gemellus inferior, the obturator internus, it will be inserted on to the medial surface of the greater trochanter. So origin of obturator internus will be from the pelvic surface of ischium and obturator membrane, and then it will bend at right angle and to get inserted on to the medial surface of the greater trochanter along with gemellus superior and gemellus inferior. Now the gemellus superior. The gemellus superior, it will take origin from the area just below the ischial spine. So here I have marked the origin of gemellus superior, and the gemellus inferior, it will take origin from the area just above the ischial tuberosity. So now the insertion of the three muscles, as we have already discussed, the gemellus superior, tendon of obturator internus and the gemellus inferior, they collectively will be inserted onto the medial surface of the greater trochanter. So here in the dissection we can see the three muscles, that is the gemellus superior, tendon of obturator internus and the gemellus inferior. All the three, they are collectively inserted onto the medial, this is the greater trochanter, and all these three, they are inserted onto the medial surface of the greater trochanter. Regarding the nerve supply of these muscles, the piriformis muscle, it will be supplied by a nerve to piriformis from the sacral plexus, and the gemellus superior and the obturator internus, both will be supplied by the nerve to obturator internus from the sacral plexus, while the gemellus inferior, it will be supplied by the nerve to quadratus femoris. Now regarding the origin of quadratus femoris, the quadratus femoris, it will take origin from the outer border of the ischial tuberosity. So here we can see this ischial tuberosity, and from the outer border of ischial tuberosity, quadratus femoris will take origin, and it will be inserted onto the quadrate tubercle in the mid of this intertrochanteric crest on the posterior surface of the femur. So this one is the intertrochanteric crest, and here I have marked the quadrate tubercle. So origin from the ischial tuberosity and insertion is onto the quadrate tubercle. In the dissection here we can see this muscle, that is the quadratus femoris, between the ischial tuberosity and the greater trochanter. So this is the ischial tuberosity and this one is the greater trochanter. And from the ischial tuberosity up to the quadrate tubercle is the muscle, that is the quadratus femoris. Nerve supply of quadratus femoris, it is by the nerve to quadratus femoris from the sacral plexus. Now the obturator externus muscle. The obturator externus muscle, it will take origin from the outer surface of ischiopubic ramus and the outer surface of the margins of obturator foramen, and from the outer surface of the obturator membrane. From here the muscle obturator externus, it will pass to get inserted on to the trochanteric fossa on the medial surface of the greater trochanter. The nerve supply of obturator externus, it is from the posterior division of the obturator nerve. So this is the only muscle which will be supplied by the branches of the lumbar plexus. All other muscles in the gluteal region, they will be supplied by the branches from the sacral plexus. Now about the origin of tensor facial artery muscle. The tensor facial artery muscle, it will take origin from the outer lip of the iliac crest, and it will extend from anterior superior iliac spine up to the tubercle of the iliac crest. So this marked part, it is the origin of the tensor facial artery muscle. And insertion of this muscle, we can see from the dissection. The tensor, this is the tensor facial artery muscle, and it is also inserted onto the iliotibial tract, that is the thickened part of facial artery. Both the muscles, the gluteus maximus and the tensor facial artery, they are inserted into the iliotibial tract, and through this attachment, both these muscles, they tend to stabilize the pelvis on the knee. The nerve supply of tensor facial artery, it is also by the superior gluteal nerve. So gluteus medius, gluteus minimus and the tensor facial artery, the three muscles, they will be supplied by the superior gluteal nerve. In addition to the function of stabilization of the pelvis, the tensor facial artery, it will be also an abductor and medial rotator of the thigh, and it through the iliotibial tract, it will also help in extension of the knee joint. Now we will identify the structures that are the vessels and nerves which are present in the gluteal region. The key muscle of the gluteal region is the piriformis muscle, and vessels and the nerves, they will be identified in relation to the piriformis muscle. Now the vessels and nerves at the upper border of the piriformis, these are the superior gluteal nerve and vessels. They will supply the gluteus medius and minimus and tensor facial artery muscle. Now at the lower border of the piriformis, we can see this inferior gluteal nerve and vessels, then posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh, and this large nerve, this is the sciatic nerve at the lower border of the piriformis. The three structures which are named as the pin structures and which are crossing the dorsal surface of the ischial spine, they can be identified as from medial to lateral side. These are, first is this pudendal nerve, then we have the internal pudendal vessels, and third is the nerve to obturator internus. So all these structures, they will pass through the greater sciatic foramen. But the three structures which are the pin structures, they will come out through the greater sciatic foramen and they will enter back into the lesser sciatic foramen. And these structures we have already seen, just revising them. These are the pudendal nerve, internal pudendal vessel and nerve to obturator internus. So they will pass through the greater sciatic notch and they will enter back into the perineal region through the lesser sciatic notch. So these are the various structures, muscles, vessels and nerves of the gluteal region.